introducing the contenders for the gold medal of the 2007 Meteksan Archery World Cup, Stage 3. Shooting on target number one, Korea. Choi Yoon-yong, Lee Tuk-yong, Park Sung-hoon. Their opponents on target number two, Italy. Pia Carmen Leonetti, Elena Parasini, Natalia Valeva. Our FIDE international judge for the match is Bergen Delia. Shooting first on target number two will be Italy. 24 arrows will decide which of these teams will take home the gold. It is a big adjustment, especially with recurve bow this late in the day because of the way the sun comes in to switch sides of the field. That's 9 points. Just out of 10. Choi taking line for Korea on target one. Italy with a score of 25, possible 30 on those first three arrows. 21 arrows to go for Italy, a full complement of 24 shots for Korea. 9 points. Just out of the 10 ring, it's a 9. On the line for Korea, the world record holder with the legendary 1405, the hero of recurve archers everywhere, is Pop. Opening with an 8 on that shot, total score 26 points, Italy with 25, Korea with a 1 point lead after the first 3 arrows. Nine points. Points. Seven points. And that is just out of the 10 ring, it's a 9. Compound archers have one very distinct advantage besides the mechanical advantage of the compound bow over the recurve bow. That is, they have a rear sight in the bowstring. Recurve shooter doesn't have a rear sight. As a result, when the lighting changes or moving from one side of the field to another, experience changes in windage from left to right on the Recurve bow. That may be one of the phenomena we're seeing here, as both teams are putting arrows out to the left side slightly. There isn't any wind to really account for it. It's probably a perception issue, looking at the bows in a certain way to make them shoot one side or the other. 51 points on the board for Korea, and an unusually low score for both teams, 50 points for Italy. It is going to be Italy shooting first when we resume. Women's team is the holder of the world record. Italy shooting first on target. European champion and Olympic medalist Natalia Labor. Eight points for all person of Italy. If you're currently in any online right now, target number two. Italy 67, a loss of 80 points. Low right on a couple of shots, but really everything's low in the target. Yeah. Generally speaking, the same is true for Korea on the first hand. That's 10 points. Substantially now for Korea. 10. Now it might be said the Koreans are shooting more like Koreans. Here are 10s on that end so far. Nine points. 80 points the total for Korea, giving them a lead of 5 points after 9 arrows. Eight points. 3 consecutive debates now for the team from Italy. That's a 9. Now this stage, after 12 arrows, the halfway mark, we're looking at a score of 101 points on the board for Italy, an unusually low score. Safe to be said for the Korean team as well. I'm going to give up 10 points. 10. It's a 6-point lead for Korea. We're at the halfway mark in this 24-arrow gold medal match. The Meteksan Archery World Cup is brought to you in part by Meteksan Events, Kia Motors, the power is surprised, HSBC, the world's global bank, Turkish Airlines, the official airline of the Federation International de Tirol, Balmain Swiss watches, Rolling Rolex, and Minute Piano. Seven. And that's an eight. I think the spotters have it right. It probably is really a six. We'll have to see who that really is after judges get down to the target on the next scoring opportunity. Just out of the 10 ring, it's a 9.
Thank you.
9 points. And now it's just up to Korea. They want the gold medal. They have to hit a target. A total of 14 points. Tie things up. That's a 10. 10 points. Next arrow can clinch the match. Korean domination continues. Victory for Korea clinching the gold with an arrow to go. Total score 209, 23 arrows. Italy will win the silver medal. Here's the final shot for this pot. That is how it is done, ladies and gentlemen. Korea winning the gold medal, Italy winning silver. And so dominating the Recurve women's division, nothing new to the Korean team. Italy no slouch, they have been in the top five in most of the past matches in the last 2 years. Next match coming up shortly is the final match of the afternoon.